Hi everyone. Monday to me, not a good day. What we saw today for the first time in a while, we have seen it before, but it's pretty much, it was just like the last time. So the last time I can remember the market gapping up and reversing from a gap up was back on 9/19. We fell straight from there. We haven't had a good day since. Normally when we gap up higher, we rally and continue throughout the day. The gap up today, that did not work. And the NASDAQ found resistance right at its 50-day moving average, sold off 0.47% on heavier volume. Guys, that is yet another distribution day, and the distribution days continue to pile up. Also, I want you to notice TSV on a daily, nowhere near oversold. Okay, so it's getting oversold, correct. MACD, it's getting oversold, correct. But it's not rounding up. They're both heading straight down, and in nowhere is it rounding up and moving up for us to even consider going long stocks. And on a weekly, as you can see, we are nowhere near oversold levels that we have seen where significant bottoms and rallies have happened. So there's no turning up whatsoever. Also showing this, the Russell 2000, same thing on the daily. You can see we're moving straight down. There is no turning up. TSV, while in the short term, we kind of got it back above the moving average, we've moved right back below it. So the downtrend stays in effect. On a weekly, as you can see also, while we're getting near oversold levels on both of the indicators, it's still nowhere near turning up. And until we start to turn up, there's no reason to think that this market needs to rally. And we can go ahead and look at the S&P 500 the same way. S&P 500 gapped up, moved up to its 50-day moving average in reverse. Its internal indicators show no signs of being oversold and turning up either. So why would you think that it would do that? The Dow Jones Industrial Average also with the reversal, you can see on its oscillators, getting oversold on TSV, still overall big downtrend. MACD, nowhere near a low. Weekly chart, you can see if we're really looking at low points and turning points, we just don't have it. It's basically been a continuation long uptrend anyway from those October, November, December 2012 lows for the Dow Jones Industrial Average. But the bottom line is, I didn't like what I saw today. XRS is just one example that I can think off the top of my head. Broke out intraday and reversed. Another one off the top of my head that I can remember seeing is BAP. Broke out above the 50-day moving average and reversed. Remember the Mobileye gap up and reversal on Friday? That followed through with the sell-off today. Recent new longs that failed today, RWLK. That IPO looked good, yet it failed. It looked like it was about ready to really break out higher just about 5 days ago. And then Lulu, which was a bottom fishing pocket pivot point signal. The stock really did look like it bottomed out, yet it can't go higher immediately. Lost its catalyst, the max green bop, and just another indication that we might not be ready. Also, data today, I noticed that it intraday broke out and reversed lower, and that follows the poor performance I saw in FireEye on Friday. So we have these stocks that were looking like they're bottoming, not acting like they want to bottom anymore. And my biggest issue with today's overall market was the action in two stocks. GTAT's down 92%. Now listen, I know it filed for bankruptcy. I understand the news, but I'm telling you right now, if this market was healthy and if stocks were priced right, you're not going to see a stock go from $11 to 80 cents in one day. To drop 92% in one day, I don't care if the momentum traders are in it. I don't care if the algos have gone wild in this stock. To drop 92% in one day is a huge tell to me that something's really wrong. Stocks are extremely mispriced. This thing would have dropped 75%, would have been like, holy shit, not good. But 92%, something's very wrong. And also, SNSS, I know that it failed its phase three trial drug and it's a $6 stock. I could have seen this thing dropping, 75% at most, but to be almost down 80%, wow, quite a feat. Quite a feat in one day. I just would not have thought that that would happen with SNSS as it now trades all the way back to its 2012 lows. So if stocks were so healthy, and also another good sign though, the technical analysis does work. If you cut your losses, if you were trying to get this stock early and cut your losses with that big break of the 50-day moving average on heavier volume, you didn't have to worry about today because you would have already been out. Same thing with GTAT, just showing how technical analysis works. Yeah, if you were buying anywhere in this handle and thought it was going to work, well, you better believe this day was your day to completely tell you to run, run, run. And if you did that, you even got a worse fill the next day in a weaker close telling you to run, run, run. And then if you did that, you didn't have to go through that. So there are, some indications. But other indications, things are problematic. CMG was a new long, but it's immediately closing below the the 50-day moving average. That's a 50% sell. This thing should have moved higher immediately. I know Monster worked, but most of the new longs are not working. SUSP was a recent long. Big reversal here. So it ended. It was flat the first day. That's good. Got a good fill, 255.03. But this intraday reversal on that big volume surge with BOP getting that weak with so many stocks showing me reversal patterns, not good. So that's going to be a 75% sell. CMG 50. Federal Express can't really handle those new highs, keeps reversing on well above average volume. This time it's closing below the 10-day moving average on above average volume and red BOP. That's going to be a 25% sell. MDVN, another recent long, not moving higher immediately. Nothing wrong with it, but the open of our signal date was 98.87. A close at 98.81 is lower than 98.87. That means it's a 50% sell. I don't care that volume was lower and BOP increased. My internals tell me something's wrong, MACD, TSV, so I will obey that. And then also TPL. Why isn't this one 100% sell? Yeah, it could be. You could easily sell 100% of it. But what I want to see now that I know that it's failed the 50-day moving average. Remember, this is its first close below the 50-day moving average. So no matter what, this would never be a full sell anyway unless we just went long somewhere in July, which we did, but we took all of our profits following this horrible day in September. But we still have a 100% gain in this stock from the signal date of 10/22. If we were not up 100% with the break from this pattern of a stock that's clearly topped to me, like I clearly said that it topped back here when it actually topped. We took profits immediately back here on 9.3 and 9.4. We took our profits. But it does look like it's completely topped, but still, crazier things have happened. It'd be stupid to sell all of it here and then see it run to 300. So it's a 50% sell. Another confirmation close below the 50-day moving average on heavier volume. It's a full sell. No need to wait to the 200-day moving average. But since we still have a 100% gain, I can wait to the 200-day moving average. But that's it. There are no longs. There are no ads. And like I said, I see problems everywhere. There's a leader, EMES. Remember the little gem TSEM that I liked? It's now looking really bad. SLXP. Look at that breakdown below the 50-day moving average on heavy volume. Not good. Look at the recent leader SMCI. Not good. Look at ETE. Not good. So we have some pretty big bad patterns out there. Semiconductor index is starting to get weak again. Probably should go short it this time around. But since I won't, that means it's probably going to be up 5% tomorrow. But the bottom line is I got some pretty nasty action. Look at LRAD. Remember that hot stock? Look at DGLY. Remember that hot stock? Looks like they're about to reverse lower. Then you had CMRX today. Big reversal off the highs. Looks like a short candidate to me with TKMR. So our hot day trading stocks are not so hot anymore. And just more reasons to be short-term concerned about this market. Unless you're myopic and you only focus on this stock. If you're only looking at this stock, yeah, we made a hell of a bad mistake not buying this one on 818 or buying this one on the breakout to new highs on 828. Big, big, big mistake. But if you're only focusing on this stock, yeah, the market looks great. But if you look anywhere else, it's not the case. Thank you.